Good evening. Treasurer Jack Snelling is gambling on the privatisation of SA Lotteries to bring our state out of the red. His first budget is in deficit to the tune of more than $250 million, and South Australians will feel it. Political reporter Adam Todd joins us live from Parliament House. Adam, which areas are hardest hit?
Well, Beck, $400 million worth of infrastructure projects have been delayed, including upgrades to railways and hospitals. 400 public servants will lose their jobs over the next 2 years. Now, the Treasurer said he had to make the cuts to keep the government's debt levels down and ensure the state kept its AAA credit rating. I can report ratings agencies have just revealed that the state has kept its AAA rating on the back of this budget. Now, if there's a headline measure from Jack Snelling's first budget, it's probably the outsourcing of the FSA lotteries. The government said it decided to outsource the lotteries, but won't reveal its asking price. It says major beneficiaries such as hospitals won't be too adversely affected. This, of course, is the Rand government's first budget without Kevin Foley in charge of the state's coffers.
New treasurer, new image.
Sure, we're different people and we have a different approach to things, but I think Kevin would recognise that as well.
Even Kevin Foley's austere blue budget cover has a friendlier face and a family photo inside. But beyond the happy snaps, it's a less joyful document.
We've got a very tight budget. There is very little new expenditure in this budget.
The government will remain in deficit to the tune of $263 million, rather than last year's forecast $55 million surplus, a return to the black forecast next financial year. $400 million of major projects will be delayed, the first homeowners grant phased out, and SA Lotteries leased to a private operator. Jack Snelling says governments shouldn't be gambling.
Well, it's an economic decision and a moral decision. I mean, it's the right economic thing to do, and it's the right thing to do by South Australian taxpayers.
Debt will peak at $4.2 billion in 2013-14. To keep debt levels from blowing out further, the Treasurer has delayed infrastructure spending, including the electrification of the Outer Harbour Rail Line and upgrades at the Queen Elizabeth and Noarlunga hospitals.
We had to make some changes to make sure that our debt was going to remain at levels that are sustainable with AAA credit ratings.
Government fees and charges will rise by an average 2.9%. A public transport ticket to cost 10 cents more, registering the average family car up $22, driver's licences up $90. An extra 400 public service jobs to go over the next 2 years.
Well, I don't agree that the public service is cut to the bone.
But leave loading rights will be restored. New expenditure includes $69 million for child protection, $37 million for the disabled, and $19 million for new breast screening technology.
Now, as you've just heard, net debt is expected to peak at $4.2 billion. The opposition says that's way too high and will leave government and taxpayers paying the price for generations to come.
Well, this is a budget that delivers higher debt, a higher deficit, and all in all, higher taxes and charges to be paid by the people of South Australia. Our debt is blowing out. They'd already budgeted for it to go out to $7.5 billion. That was going to cost the people of this state $2 million a day in interest. They're now pushing that even further out. That's now going to go out to $8.1 billion.
Now, about 200 protesters gathered here on the steps of Parliament for another union rally. There were a few concessions for unions in the budget, such as a return of leave loading entitlements. But with more job cuts to come, the Public Service Association's Jan McMahon says they'll continue to fight.
We are appalled and disappointed by a further 400 public sector jobs to go. This will impact on South Australian families. We will continue to campaign against the job cuts because they, quite frankly, just equal service cuts.
Now join us at 5:30 when we speak to the man himself, Treasurer Jack Snelling. Back to you, Beck.